Hey guys, this is Nate Story with Brad Agrotech, and today we're going to do a quick video on HVAC and what it means to indoor growers. So HVAC is heating, ventilation, and air conditioning, and what it describes is the systems that take indoor air, circulate it around, treat it, and either cool it down, heat it up, or dehumidify it. So most growers use HVAC in some way, shape, or form. And especially as you get more and more intensive, HVAC becomes more and more critical to the success of your operation. So if you're doing a very, very small setup, you may get away without using HVAC. But the larger you get, once you start doing CO2 supplementation, once you start to basically dehumidify your air fairly aggressively or cool your air because you've got so many lights, HVAC becomes a critical part of your operation. HVAC is an expensive CapEx, and it can be a fairly expensive operating expense as well. So HVAC is not cheap, especially as we get more and more intensive. As we cram more plants into less space, we have more issues with humidity. We have more issues with mold and fungi and all of the kind of things that happen when we just cram a lot of plants together. We also have much, much higher cooling costs for most growing environments, and that's just because when you cram those plants together and really light them up, you create a lot of heat that you need to take care of. You know, systems vary in quality and they vary in price, but ultimately they're going to be within a certain range. Now, the big difference in my mind and in our minds is between traditional condenser-based air conditioning systems and water chillers. So we tend to move more towards water cooling than air cooling. And the reason that we do that is we like to water cool our lights. It gives us a little bit more control over the growing environment. And we've found that we can actually run a whole bunch of other types of equipment on chilled water a little bit easier, more efficiently as a grower than we can with these big bulky air conditioning systems. So one thing you have to think about with HVAC is your intent to scale. And that's something that you should be thinking about. If you intend for your farm to be a lot bigger down the road, then I would invest in a higher quality system that can be scaled over time. You can buy some really small, cheap options, but those are really only reliable or doable on a very small scale. So if you intend to get big, if you intend to make money, if you intend to scale your facility, it's worth putting aside a budget just for HVAC. Yeah, there are lots of ways that you can reduce your HVAC costs. You know, the simplest way is to just rely on a lot of ventilation if you're in an area where the air is typically cool enough that you can cool your facility with outside air. Now, that introduces all sorts of other problems, right? You can bring in pests. It's an imperfect solution because sometimes it's very hot outside and it's very hot inside. But ultimately, you know, that's by far the cheapest way to get some of this work done. Most folks that are really serious that want fine-tuned and high levels of control have to go over to a commercial HVAC system, and those become much more expensive. Now, how expensive it is ultimately depends on how big the system is. So the bigger the system is, the cheaper it gets on a per ton basis, and also then the local installation costs. And we found these to be very, very variable across the United States and across the world. For most growers, you can get into pretty reasonable systems if you have a relatively large setup. One thing that we've really looked at is how we take 5 and 7 ton chillers and use combinations of 5 and 7 ton chillers scaled to cool very large facilities efficiently. If you already have a method for heating and cooling, then you kind of already have some level of rudimentary HVAC. Now, the question to ask yourself is whether you could get more out of it if it was a HVAC system that was really purpose-built for your facility. That means purpose-built for air filtration, purpose-built for dehumidification, purpose-built around the equipment that you're running. So if you have so many lights in your environment, you know what kind of BTUs you're producing, and you can size your HVAC system appropriately. Those are the kinds of things that you really need to be thinking about. We like to do some of the HVAC ourselves, or at least reduce the cost of HVAC by using water chillers to chill our lights. And we can do that pretty much all in-house, and that reduces our overall HVAC costs significantly. But depending on your lighting type and depending on your situation, those costs can be pretty darn high, especially once you get into purpose-built systems. However, I would say that most of the time, a purpose-built system is worth it. So there are lots of resources out there on HVAC if you want to learn more. And there are increasingly more and more of these becoming available. The first place I'd go is to Upstart University. We've got a great webinar up at Upstart University. I think it's $10 to access the webinar. It's also $10 for a month subscription to USU, and it's free through USU. So it's probably worth just getting a month subscription to Upstart University and watching the webinar, and then of course, checking out some of the other resources there. We also will have some blog posts coming out on this subject. So we're going to try and get you the best possible information through the blog. Make sure you check that out. Thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, please subscribe. Subscriptions are how we measure our success. It's how we measure whether what we're producing is something that you guys want and something that you guys need. It's also a way for us to get you the most timely and the best possible information to you directly instead of having to go out and try and find this crazy stuff on the intertubes. So make sure you tune in, make sure you subscribe, and we'll look forward to getting a lot more great content to you in the future.